When it comes to the U.S. auto industry, it doesn't get any more American than a truck. Specifically, this truck, the Ford F-150. In 2023, it was the best-selling car in the country for the 42nd year in a row. But if you look just a few more spots down, you'll find Tesla's Model Y, a fully electric vehicle. So mixing them together would be a great idea, right? America's favorite vehicle plus America's favorite rising trend. Electric trucks were born. What could go wrong? Apparently, a lot.
The F-150 Lightning is on hold as the automaker issues a stop ship order on its all-electric pickup.
EV truck sales in America are in the dumps, and they aren't picking up any steam. Yeah, the math ain't mathin'. Since 2021, automakers like Rivian with the R1T, GM with the GMC Hummer EV, Ford with this F-150 Lightning, and even Tesla with the Cybertruck have all invested serious money into creating electric trucks. Clearly, they believed in a potentially booming market. F-Series is America's best-selling truck for 44 years. Now we are revolutionizing it for a new generation. Ford said it was building an EV that solves real problems for real people. At first, things looked promising. Ford received nearly 200,000 reservations for its Lightning release in 2021. But once the initial excitement wore off, Ford and his industry partners quickly realized consumer demand was a fraction of what they expected. So what went wrong? Well, it boils down to three main issues, one of which should have definitely been flagged in the boardroom. First, I reached out to an EV truck owner who's selling his F-150 Lightning on Craigslist. Why did you buy an EV truck?
I bought the EV truck because I've already owned a few electric vehicles. I somewhat regret it now.
Originally, how much did you pay for that truck?
I'm leasing it, and I believe it's priced at about $80,000.
And that's deterrent number one, price. The F-150 Lightning was initially marketed as an affordable EV truck, but its price rose significantly by $20,000 in just 2 years. The company cited supply chain issues and high material costs. Even if you are able to afford the purchase price, you're still not out of the woods. If and when you need a replacement battery, it's gonna cost you. A replacement battery for a Tesla Model 3 costs between $7,000 and $16,000, while a replacement battery for the Lightning would cost up to
$35,960 for just the part. No tax, no installation, nothing.
Tack on the cost of charging the truck, about $1,100 a year. Compare that to the Tesla Model 3, which costs about $550 annually. All right, so you're probably watching this video right now thinking the same thing I was thinking at this point. Okay, so the cost is too high. That's why they failed. Case closed. The end. Bye. But even if you have the money, these trucks simply can't do the job that many folks require pickups to do. Remember that expensive battery from earlier? Well, there's another issue.
What's the weight of the battery? You have an idea?
The weight of the battery is 1,800 pounds.
That's the equivalent of six refrigerators. The F-150 Lightning weighs upwards of 6,000 pounds. For comparison, the gas-powered F-150 weighs up to 4,600 pounds. If you're towing heavy loads, the range for these trucks drops dramatically.
As soon as the truck detected that there's a trailer connected, I received a message displayed on the dash stating a trailer has been detected. 50% of your range is gone. My Chevy that I had, High Country Silverado, it was a diesel. I was getting about 30 miles per gallon in it. Four-wheel drive, I could tow easily. I had no issues. And on a full tank of fuel, you could go about 700 miles without having to worry about it.
I'm not a genius or anything, but chances are, if you're the type of person who wants to buy a pickup truck, you probably want to use it to pick things up. The hefty weight combined with reduced range when towing makes these trucks less practical for heavy-duty tasks, limiting their appeal. And the challenges don't stop there. There are over 178,000 certified automobile technicians in the U.S. Currently, there are less than 2,000 automotive experts who are certified to handle EV repairs. Traditional mechanics can manage basic maintenance, but not complex EV systems, y'all. While electric trucks have fewer moving parts than traditional internal combustion vehicles, their maintenance isn't as straightforward as you may think. Unlike EVs from companies like Tesla, which have well-established infrastructures and a wealth of experience, electric trucks are still developing. We've been through the high cost, the weight, and the maintenance challenges. Those three things make a lot of sense, but in my research, I found something wrong with the whole core of this model. Remember when Ford said, "Now we're revolutionizing it for a new generation"? Well, that market may never have been there. It could simply be that the market is split into two distinct groups, the EV buyer and the pickup truck buyer. EV buyers live in suburban neighborhoods, make a higher income, love tech and the environment. And then there are pickup truck buyers. They're usually older and live in rural settings. If you combine the two, you get a truck-loving environmentalist who'd be the perfect consumer for the EV truck industry. But here's the thing, that perfect consumer might not be real. Plain and simple, the people who want EVs generally don't want trucks, and the people who want trucks generally don't want EVs. According to a study from automotive market analytics firm Auto Pacific, pickup truck buyers are the most resistant to going electric, with only 12% saying they'd want a fully electric vehicle. They're also the most ingrained in their opinions about trucks. But it's not just about the trucks themselves. There's a deeper divide.
Hey, that thing got a Hemi.
I'm a Ford truck man. That's all I drive.
A tougher, meaner animal.
One other aspect of this whole thing is the massive political divide in this country. As highlighted in this Jalopnik article, folks who buy pickup trucks are mostly Republicans. Meanwhile, people leaning towards smaller cars tend to be Democrats. Democrats usually want cars that are eco-friendly, economical, and cool, while Republicans go for something powerful, rugged, and prestigious. And that's the core problem here. Auto manufacturers pushing EV trucks clearly underestimated this divide. But even though the industry has seen better days, it still has a pulse. Ford cut prices, $2,000 off the standard model and $5,500 off the extended range. It's a start. The standard range now targets 240 miles, up from 230. Sales were up 80% early 2024 from 2023, with over 7,700 units sold. This is a sign of life, but the heartbeat the industry needs to thrive is missing. But other options may be coming soon. A company called Zero Labs is offering to build you a completely new classic EV truck or convert your existing truck into an EV. They offer conversion kits intended to cost between $35,000 and $55,000. If you like this story and want to learn more, subscribe to the Hustle YouTube channel for more business and tech stories just like this.